Good morning. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. I'm Bishop Coletta Javon at the School of the Holy Spirit, and we are so excited to be here with you on our way to Pentecost. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Those of you that are joining us from different time zones, come on in. We are so glad that you're here. Good morning to my Instagram family. Good morning to those of you that are joining us live and those of you that are on the replay. This is an exciting time. We are living on the cusp of a new Pentecost. They call it the third wave. That is what is happening. The man is the keeper. It's on IG. Come on. Good morning to my IG family. Come on and let's grow. Let's grow. LaVon Watson, John Davis, Bishop Herbert Jackson. Oh, I'm going back to some of those scriptures, that Roman text. God bless you. And don't forget him at 5:45. He is my get ready prayer. My get ready intercession. Praise God. Glory, Edamande. Yes, yes, in the sanctuary. Good morning. I'm so glad that you joined us. And please don't forget to go to our website at www.gotellit.org and get your ticket for March 31st. You go to Eventbrite and get those tickets for the gala. 50 years, Deborah Brown, 50 years. Oh, my God. 50 years. Unbelievable. My little sister, my God, my mommy, my daddy, my little firstborn baby, Shannon. 1972, we walked into 935 Alger. No, I didn't see it, Dion. I got to go back and watch. Yesterday, I was deep in homework. They received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Wow, Asbury. Come on, As. I don't know what they're going to do with that. That's going to be amazing to see how they actually are going to handle that. That's going to be amazing to see how they're going to handle, how that's going to evolve. It's an outpouring. Okay, thank you, Dion. I will go and see it. You know, I wants to know. I really want to go. Yeah, I'm thinking about going. My schedule is so busy. Oh my God, I just thought. But I want to go. I want to be, you know, I wants to see. I'm too nosy not to go. Glory to God, Monica Monet. Come on, go with me. Wanda Sue, good morning, Gertis Lee, Victoria Felder, Pastor John Davis, y'all to come go with me. Come on, Miyoshi Dossie, good morning, daughter. Pearl Evans, God bless you. Monica, we gotta go. Charlotte Green, hey sugar. Welcome, Camilla Cook. Woo, we are so ready. Me too. Hey, good morning. God bless you. And welcome to my Instagram family. Welcome to my Zoomers this morning. God bless you. Thank you so much for being a part of what God is doing. All of you matter so much. Good morning, Overseer Ryan. Get them in here. Praise God. Good morning, Dr. Felicia, my team. Those is my covering angels. Sandra Coleman told me, she said, oh, you're not going to believe this, Bishop. I'm reading the Bible. I'm like, yeah. Wonderful. Pastor William Lamont, Barbara Dogan, Deborah Sharp, Gloria Jean Pitts, Harris, hey sissy, Gloria Dean Flora, good morning, Pearl Evans, good morning, Evangelist Akiba. Listen, you need to celebrate and come with me to the gala. Holy Ghost Cathedral is 50 years, 50 years, 1972 to 2022 is 50 years. We didn't celebrate last year due to the gathering and COVID, was still a little careful. And so this year we are celebrating. You get your tickets on our website. You can do the general admission of $150, or you can do the dais admission, which is a little extra, some perks for you there. Or if you cannot come, you can be a patron. If you have a ministry or business, or you just want to be a sponsor, you can sponsor a table, or you can sponsor a digital ad that will be shown there. So you don't want to miss that. I want you to pray for my body. I woke up this morning, had a little something going on, but praise God, I want you to keep me in your prayers. And I know you all do. I know you do. Go to Eventbrite and get your tickets. Or you can go to their IG page. They close Asbury Public. Really? Wow. So the students can still come, but not the public. Answer me back on that. That's interesting. I'm watching how they're planning to do this. I really want to see how they plan to do this. It's going to be interesting to see how they actually plan to pull this off. Jeff JR, what's up this morning? Lady Watts, God bless you. Camilla, in Jesus' name, thank you. Yeah, I woke up and had some kind of little attack going, but I feel great. Good morning to the new grand. Pastor Vanessa, you all are off this week. Schools are out for spring break. Dean Nicholson, Leatrice Fuller Ellis, welcome. Denise K. Mosley, Lady Vicey, God bless you. Sharon Richmond Williamson, Hawana Ferguson, Jolika Taylor, Forever Blessed 70, Baldwin 9914. Hey, y'all, enjoy, enjoy. Yes, I see it. Some of you are trying to get in to our Zoom page, but if I don't recognize your name, we had some really weird stuff that has been happening. So if I don't recognize your name, I don't open that up for you. Listen, I want to talk to us a little bit about what's going on at Asbury, a little bit about what is going on just all over the world. So there's a new university that has caught fire in Texas. Praise God. And I'm excited about you guys. Oh my God. Listen. Okay. Let me calm down. Hold on. Let me calm down. You know, when I started doing From the Tomb to the Upper Room, it's been almost 10 years. So those were 40 days from resurrection to Pentecost. And then in 2020, Galen Thompson, Perlina Woods, Mama Pearl Evans, Angela Quick, Arnita Copeland, good morning. Then in 2020, Holy Spirit said that we were to do Pentecost in a pandemic. And so we have been very faithful. Thank you. Thank you, Elon. Thank you. And so I'm just excited about what God is doing. And one of the words that the Lord gave me by the Spirit. Thank you, Deborah Wilson. Thank you. Thank you so much, Eventbrite. You can get your tickets. You can go to our website, www.gotellit.org/gala. You can get your tickets right there on the website. But one of the words that Holy Spirit gave me was that he was going to spread out Holy Spirit like satellites. How many of you all remember that word? Angela Marshall, good morning, my Sarah. Margaret Johnson, hey, darling, good morning. Pastor Rita Beal, good morning. Yes, and Vandellic, he said that he was going to, I could see pockets, I could see satellites, and that those of you that were in the class, School of Holy Spirit, that you would be leading this move, that you would be equipped to lead this move, that you would be a part of accelerating and populating this next third wave. Now, some say third, some say fourth, but God said that you would be a part of this work. Good morning to my spiritual director, my sister. Good morning, Dina Dawkins, Dr. Jessica Ingram, Kim 1297. Hey, wifey, I love it. And I'm watching it, Sylvia Spikes, Bishop Jackson. You remember that? When God said, he said that there would be an outpouring of his spirit that's going to hit the earth that's been second to none since Azusa, that it would be even greater, praise God. Camilla, I am so excited that we are in this move of God, that we are in the glory. But just to remind us, Juanita, that as Brenda Malloy, that God spoke it almost 3 years ago, that these breakouts would begin to happen. Yvonne Reynolds, Pamela Plummer Matthews, Betty Mathis, let's go. That these breakouts would happen. Now, they're calling it a revival. I don't believe that it has reached revival level yet, but it's headed in that direction. Right now, we call it an outpouring. Now, I also heard that I guess somebody went viral on TikTok. I don't know. I've got to watch it. Christianity Today, as one of the Asbury professors says, we're witnessing a surprising work of God. Nonstop worship gathering at a Kentucky school echoes one of the older moves, echoes in an old Christian tradition. So now it's been rolling for 2 weeks. People have flown from across the country, standing in line. One of my sisters is there, Bishop Paul Lanier, Debbie Lanier is there, and her son, Paul, and they're all outside. It's cold, and people are outside, and they are outside ministering to each other. They are ministering to each other on the inside. The line is quite long for people to get in. So this is really something that's happening. So revivals, most times, are meetings that begin to go into the culture. Holy Spirit has a move, and it starts going into the culture. Now, they're calling it evangelicalism, but it's really Pentecostalism. It's amazing how we try to make everything evangelicalism, evangelical. But this isn't evangelical. This is Pentecostal. And so now we are waiting to see if there's going to be healings, if there's going to be deliverance. You know, we've got to begin to see. Mother Pearl, we're praying for you as well. Sandra Goldsby. There is a report. Yes, absolutely. Okay, so there's an outpouring in Cedarville, Ohio. And Sanford, yes, Birmingham, Alabama. Sanford has picked it up as well. Praise God. So these are young people, what we call Generation Z, that are embracing Holy Spirit, Sonia Neal Anderson, Jarena Storm, that God is causing people to go to the campus. Brenda Skillman says she lives in Kentucky. Over 20,000 people were actually on the campus. Now, what does that say? Yes, I am Lil Wilson. Good morning, darling. Good morning to my Union family, Dr. Anika, and all of my family there at Union. Over 20,000 have gathered, and that's on the outside, on the inside. So they're singing songs. They are crying out to God. People are lifting their hands. People are enveloped in the presence of God. And this began on February 8th as one of their normal chapel services. Praise God. Unrehearsed, no one famous being brought in, no one, but just people hungry for God. Praise God. Holy Spirit is moving all over the land. And we have been assigned as the students of Holy Spirit School and as believers, baptized Holy Spirit filled believers, that we must pray for the Lord of the harvest, pray that God would send laborers, pray that there would be an excellent, that there would be great embracing of what God is doing in multiple campuses. I'm on the campus of Liberty University, and I'm really praying that there would be an outpouring there. Of course, even at Pentecostal Theological Seminary, I'm not taking courses this semester because they didn't have what I needed, but I'm still an enrolled student there. And they, who are Church of God, Cleveland, Tennessee, need an outbreak of the Holy Spirit. Our churches need it. So millions are hungry. The wind is moving. Bishop Frazier, your grace, welcome. Unscripted. Kai, yes, there is healing. So I want to see, Overseer Lenita, I want to see what the leadership is going to do with this. I do not see that they have stopped it. So I don't know. There might be some rumor, but it says that it is still ongoing. But I know that they are debating whether or not they're going to shut it down. I say no. I say let it flow. So now it's been closed to the public. That means only the students and their family members and the staff can attend, because of course they don't have the manpower. Hillary Ann Gardner, bless you, girl, and give my love to my sister on her birthday yesterday. Regent University, absolutely. And they teach on the renewal of Holy Spirit. Regent teaches it, but still there needs to be an activation. Holy Spirit, pour out afresh. Holy Spirit, come on, pray with me for just a moment. Holy Spirit, pray. Let's pray. Holy Spirit, intercede for us that in every space, if you're moving in the realm of academia, every space that we occupy, Regent, Liberty, Pentecostal Theological Seminary, Phoenix University, wherever we are, Holy Spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus, we ask for your outpouring, particularly schools that are identified by a denomination. Move in the public square. Move in the public square, Holy Spirit. We thank you for our churches. We thank you for our fellowships and our reformations and denominations. But Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, move in the public square that people might have a holy fear of you, God, that they would reverence you, and that the fear of the Lord would begin to guide their lives. Move, hallelujah, help me, Lord. Move in the public square. In the mighty name of Jesus, move in the public square. Hallelujah. Payne Theological Seminary. Yes. Move in Abashe in the public square. And we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Move in the public square. Move in our schools. Move in our universities. Move in our seminaries. Move in our religious affiliations. Yes, Lord. And we thank you that we are being prepared, taught, trained how to handle the third wave of Holy Spirit. And we give you the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Woo, hallelujah. Dr. Patricia James, hallelujah. Move in the public square in the powerful, mighty name of Jesus. Move in the public square. Hallelujah. Asbury is opening up alternative areas. They are considering, because they don't know what to do with this. And they are considering opening it up in other nearby campus locations for families and others to come. But they have closed the university to the public. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. Move in the public square. Dr. Aqua Copeland, in our elementary schools, in our high schools, in our middle schools, move in our private schools, move in our church-based schools, move in the public square. Oh, hallelujah. Let our children come home, hallelujah, from school and give us the report that Holy Spirit is moving in their classrooms, moving in their hallways, moving. You're the only power that's greater than the rebellion and greater than the addictions and greater than anything that is going on in our schools. Holy Spirit, you are the greater power. And we ask now that there will be a release, glory to God, in the public squares. And we give you praise. Shall we not know it? Shall we not see it? Glory to God, in our K-12 schools, in our school boards, in our superintendents, Howard University, School of Divinity, move in our public squares, move in our HBCUs, move, move in our public square locations, our marketplace, our education, our academic spaces, where they get into our minds, move in the public square. God, we give you glory. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Listen to me very carefully. This is a great season. Dr. Skillman said there are 20,000 on the campus this past weekend. I want to hear about the healings. I've not heard that. I want to see the healings and I want to see deliverance. I've not seen it yet, but I do know that people are being saved. It was reported that there were more people than they had accommodations. Absolutely. I want to know. Move in the public square, Deanna. Yes, God. And come on, y'all, join me. Hallelujah. Woo, Rebaba, University of Georgia. Come on. We'll have an outpouring. Glory to God. Move in the public square. Hallelujah. Move in Virginia Union. Yes, yes, yes. In every seminary, every school, move. Hallelujah. In our seminaries around the globe. Hallelujah. Hey, Evangelist Belinda, God bless you. We're praying, Holy Spirit, to move in the public squares. Woo, glory, glory in the name of Jesus. Now, this is what I've been priming you and wanting you to get into this understanding. Do not blaspheme the Holy Spirit. Do not grieve Holy Spirit. And do not quench Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Good morning, Cathedral. Good morning, Dr. Tracy. Hallelujah. Harvard University School of Business and their School of Divinity. Move in the public square. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you for the influx of new believers, new baptisms in the Holy Spirit. Move, God, and entreat your people Oh God, hey, hallelujah, to be able to accept all of the newness that is coming. Open our minds and open our understanding in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is Pentecost. Oh, somebody say it. This is Pentecost. And God is positioning us. Do not blaspheme. Do not grieve. And do not quench Holy Spirit. That is what I want to continue to say to us. Hallelujah. That we would not be on the outside of this move. That we would be in the center of this move of God. Hallelujah. Do not blaspheme. Do not quench. Do not grieve Holy Spirit. And one of the ways that I believe we may be unaware of our quenching the Spirit's fire is through our unbelief. I want to talk a little bit about the damage that your unbelief does to a move of God. Hallelujah. Come on and more. God bless you, Geraldine Sanders. This is Pentecost. Glory to God. Those of you that are on IG, I love y'all so much. Help me to build this community. Thank you for those of you that are on Zoom. Thank you so many are coming in. I want us to look at the subtle negative diabolical impact of unbelief. I want you to hear me today. It is so important that we do not fall into a spirit of unbelief. Someone is calling out Spelman, CAU, Morehouse, Morris Brown. Absolutely. Hallelujah. How do I quench the Spirit's fire? What are some of the ways? And remember, we're at Holy Spirit Basics 101. And so I want to deal with this because as I was praying and doing some work on yesterday, basically homework, Holy Spirit just began to deal with me about how we quench the Spirit's fire. Quench not. Do not quench the Spirit's fire. How do you quench? How would I quench the Spirit's fire? Wow, wow, wow. A whole move. Amen, amen, amen. I want to deal with this because Holy Spirit move at every school in Virginia, Maryland, Washington, D.C. Yes, God, in the name of, in the public square. Hebrews chapter number 3. I want you to go there for just a moment. Hebrews chapter 3. And let's look at verse 12. Hebrews chapter number 3. Hallelujah. Thank you, Deborah Phillips. I appreciate you, baby. Dr. Kadisha, God bless you. Read a bit. Many times we are snared by our own unbelief. Our own unbelief. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Chapman says that he is applied to Regency University. Absolutely. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. I remember when that school was on fire. Dr. Don Petrie, who was a part of Edelson World Outreach Ministries, was the dean of the Divinity School. He wrote the curriculum for Regent University, and he was the dean there of the Divinity School. And when he began to write, and Pat Robinson opened up the school, Regent University. It was Don Petrie who was a part of our ministry at Itahosura Outreach. He wrote the curriculum, and it was intentional to be a renewal theology. It's the school that in its moment was the antithesis, if you will, to the Dallas Theological Seminary and to the King's Theological Seminary, which of course were cessational, or those schools that taught against the move of the Holy Spirit. So when Pat Robinson opened up the school, Dr. Petrie was the dean. And he wrote for them so that it would be a move of Holy Spirit on that campus at all times. Since that time, since it became very entrenched in politics. So there is a need even for all of us, Rutgers, Montclair State, absolutely. For all of our schools, Fowler Dickinson University, New Jersey, New York Theological Seminary, all of these places, to have a renewal of Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Wow. Listen to this. Bonita, she said, Bishop, I found this. I can't read that, what that is, but you'll give it back to me. Last night, Twyla and I decided to go to Asbury to experience God's presence in the revival. On our way there, I was praying, asking God to heal a newly discovered chronic health issue that arose over the past several weeks. Wow. Okay. We're standing with you. Amen. I'm waiting to see a breakout. And certainly we want that to be your testimony. Let our children catch on fire. University of Pittsburgh, Penn State, Temple University, absolutely. West Virginia University. Wow. Camilla says, I worked for CBN for 10 years. Wow. As a worship leader and prayer warrior on the set. Oh my God. Ashland Theological Seminary. Yes, God. Oh, it was David Bennett's. Okay. I see. I got it. Well, I'm waiting to hear of the miracles and the healings. And I believe that it's going to come. So here's what we want to. Here's what we want to prepare our hearts. And that is to not be found in a place of unbelief. To not be found in a place of unbelief. Hebrews chapter number 3, verse 11 and 12. Brethren, beware, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief, departing from the living God. Wow. But exhort one another every day, as long as you call it today, that none of you would be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. And I want to help you here. The deceitfulness of this sin of unbelief. Detroit Bible Institute. This sin of unbelief. Now, sometimes it is called skepticism, or I just need to be smart about it. I want you to hear this. The heart of unbelief is a sinful heart. It's a sinful heart. Geraldine Sanders coming up the timeline. Praise God. This move will bring unlegislated prayer. Absolutely. Absolutely. Can't be stopped. It's coming. Glory to God. I want to deal with how you quench the Spirit's fire. How would I quench it? I'm smarter than that. I wouldn't do that. But how do we quench the Spirit's fire? Is through a evil heart of unbelief. You cannot imagine how many people still don't believe that there is spirit baptism, or that tongues and interpretation of tongues, that miracles, that the word of knowledge, that the word of wisdom, that the supernatural gifts are still available for us. We're going to focus on some other ways in which are more obvious. But I want to get into, for the next couple of days, a more subtle way in which we quench the Spirit's fire. Good morning, Pastor James, Otis Dupree. When we start moving in, no, doubt is the manifestation of unbelief. So doubt is the symptom, unbelief is the sin. I don't believe it. You know, we may not be that bold, but you doubt it. You doubt it. And so that is a sign of unbelief, And many of us practice unbelief so regularly that we're not even aware that we are participating in unbelief. In the name of Jesus. Many of us don't even recognize that we have a heart of unbelief. I hear people say, well, prove it to me, you know, prove it to me. Well, where is that in the Bible? Right. Okay. And whenever I run into somebody like that, good morning, Sonya Royster. Good morning, Barbara Samuel, Charmaine Coleman. Dr. Michael Colbert, good morning, son. Listen, when people say that, show that to me in the Bible. Even if I show it to you, it's not going to change it because you have a heart of unbelief. And I want to caution us about this. This sinful heart of unbelief, skepticism, doubt. These are nice names. Whenever someone says to me, oh, well, you know, I don't believe, you know, this, or, you know, I don't think it's, you know, for today, you know, I told you the other day, someone was on my page and they were talking about every time someone speaks in tongues, they're supposed to interpret. Now, we know that's not true. But as smart as they're trying to sound, it really is unbelief talking. Unbelief. It says, and the day, verse 15, that you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. Okay, I want you to hear this. Hallelujah. Do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. Watch this. Verse 16, for who having heard rebelled? Indeed, was it not all who came out of Egypt led by Moses? Now, with whom was he angry 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, whose corpses fell in the wilderness? And to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest, but to those who did not obey? So we see that they could not enter in because of their unbelief. Watch this. I want you to really pick up on what I'm saying to you. I have pastors say to me, oh, I want you to come to my church. Oh, I can't wait, but my people are not ready. And I said, wow. Wow. And as smart as they think they sound. It's still unbelief. Sometimes my mother used to say to me, you so smart, you stupid. Oh, you smart? Yes, ma'am. You smart, huh? Yes, ma'am. You so smart, you stupid. I was like, wow, mom. Now, think about this for just a moment. Fabio, welcome. Thank you. Listen to this. I need you to hear this carefully. How do I quench Holy Spirit? How do I quench the fire of Holy Spirit? And sometimes the smarter you are in Scripture, now I'm going to say something. The smarter you are in Scripture, the dumber you get in spirit. Somebody write that down for me. Because that's fresh from the Holy Ghost. Woo, Rabbi Shokoto Mamasia. Woo, my God. My mama used to say, oh, you're smart. Yes, ma'am. You're so smart, you stupid. Sometimes the smarter we get, you know, we go to school, we write all these papers, we read all these books, we cite all these references. And many times the smarter that you get, the dumber you get in spirit. Because I believe that the reason that there are a lot of schools for divinity training and seminary training is to make you not believe. In their own subtle way, they are trying to get you to unbelieve. So sometimes the smarter you get in Scripture, the dumber you get in spirit. And that's the trick. That's the subtlety. Woo! Come in. Come on in here, somebody. Come on. My God. And so when you begin to get dumb, you dummy down in the spirit, you know, now you start, you know, you start getting, you know, so smart. Well, you know, certain scriptures said so-and-so and certain scriptures said so-and-so, you know, and amen. But when you begin to unbelief. Now let's work with the epistemology of the word un in the Greek or even in the English is to take away. To un is to take away. All right? To un is to take away. So believe and then you take it away. You take it away. Many preachers that are preaching now, they were preaching and then they got to school and they learned how to write homilies and they learned how to exegete the text. And now they're so focused on preaching that preaching now becomes the everything, the be all do all, when preaching is a means to an end. It was never intended to be the end all, be all to all. It was a means to the end. And so the preaching of the word was to bring faith. And faith cometh by hearing was to produce a move of God. And we have made preaching so important. And I hear people say, oh, they preach. Okay, they have a skill with the text. But preaching was never supposed to be the end all be all. All right, now I'm going someplace. So watch this. How do I quench the Spirit's power? And I began to intellectualize Holy Spirit. When I began to intellectualize the move of Pentecost. Yes, Dr. Denise, that's why many people call the seminary the cemetery, because they're going to kill. They're going to take away. They're going to take it away. So on is to remove. On is to remove. On is to take away. On is to take it away. So that means that there was a point in time that you believed, but then you took it away. You believed, but then you unbelieved, which means you took it away. To un something, unlock, undo, unbelief. So to remove something that was there. So when I use my key to unlock the door, I'm taking away the lock. I'm removing the security. When I undo my lock, when I undo, I am removing that. So on is to take it away. Oh, I need you to hear me today. Woo, Rabbi Kashkoto Radamashi. And so now we have a congregation of people that don't believe. I preached this past Sunday from the Matthew 17 text, which was a part of our lectionary reading. And when they went up on the mountain of Transfiguration, three of them, Peter, James, and John. I miss Joan, I'm saying, thank you. When they went up, and then Moses shows up. Wow. And then Elijah shows up. Now they're up on the mountain with Jesus, right? And so these two prophets that came out from eternity into present and met them on the mountain of Transfiguration. Yeah, hey, Shababa Anda. Woo, Reba Baba and the Oshake, and Mama Masi. Woo, Reba Baba Baba Shika. Hallelujah. Thank you, Deborah. Oh my God. Listen, Deborah Phillips. Thank you. Watch this. And when they got up there with Jesus, the other nine were down at the bottom of the mountain. These three were up there with Jesus. Moses shows up, Elijah shows up. And then God speaks. The cloud shows up, and out of the cloud comes this voice of God. And I ask the question, as we wrestle through the text, what do you see? What do you see? And the premise of the message is that, go back to our Holy Ghost Cathedral page on Facebook, you can see it, or go up to our YouTube page, you can hear this message, is that many of us have lost our desire to see anything. We have lost our desire to participate in something so much bigger than ourselves. We have become so regular and so normal that we have lost the expectation to see something. And that is because unbelief has crept in our hearts. And we have taken away our belief. Woo, Rabbi Kishkotoda, Rabbi Kishkata. Overseer Lenita says, I went to seminary, spirit-filled, and still had to pray when I finished. to take me back to the absolutely, because they want you to unbelieve. They want you to unbelieve. They want you to put more credibility on what you can see and what you can know and what you can feel than what you believe. That's the whole point. They're moving you from the place of believing to a place of intellectualism. We don't have a desire. Some of y'all preachers are terrible. You're terrible preachers. You're awful. I listen to you. I watch you, and I can't take it. I can't take it. You don't believe half of what you preach. You don't believe none of what you believe. You don't believe the songs you sing. You don't believe. Your preaching is awful. It's terrible. I've never seen so much bad preaching in all my life. It's terrible preaching. You're terrible preachers. You think that because you put together a introduction and the body and it's terrible. You've lost. You are awful. This preaching is terrible. And the people scared to tell you that your preaching is terrible. It's terrible. You don't believe it. You're just putting something together that sounds good. You're just putting something together that, but you don't even believe it yourself. It's terrible. And it comes through that you really don't believe. It shows. It's terrible. I've never seen so much terrible preaching in my whole life. I'm like, is that preaching? That's not preaching. And because the musician covers it up, but it's nothing. It's no manifestation. It's no demonstration of the Spirit's power. It's all about you. It's all about what you learned, what you know, what you researched. But nothing that you believe. You don't believe it. Because now, unbelief is a sin. The Bible says the sinful heart of unbelief is what quenches the Spirit's power. I want you to hear me very good. Woo, Rabbi Kishkoto. Hey, woo, Rabbi Mama No Shy. I want you to hear me today. So we see that they could not enter into the promised land because of their unbelief. Woo, Rabbi, absolutely, Overseer, right? Absolutely. Woo, Shakaba. It'd take me 10 minutes to tell you how to prepare a sermon. Take me a whole 10 minutes. I might get done in 7. I'm telling you, we don't believe. We don't believe this. We don't believe it. We don't. When they got up on that mountain and Moses started talking and Elijah just started talking, because those were the two prophets that we never saw actually die. Never saw them die. So Moses was carried off. And then Elijah went up in the whirlwind. So we never saw them actually die a physical death. So they come back and meet Jesus on the mountain. Peter, James, and John are up there, and they are looking at it, and they're like, good God Almighty, we have lost our expectation of something so powerful to happen in our services, to happen in our church, to happen in our lives. We have slipped over into unbelief. Ooh, Rabbi Kashkata. Jacqueline says she did. She had a great experience at Turner. But they need a move of God. We want that to spread. Listen to me carefully.
my God, I'm telling you. And what is it that causes us to get into unbelief? It is the deceitfulness of sin. And I'm gonna really pull on this in a minute. The deceitfulness of sin. The deceitfulness of sin is what causes unbelief. We don't even believe in sin no more. We don't even believe in judgment and punishment, church discipline anymore. Let's not even deal with signs and wonders. Let's just deal with church discipline. Leadership. I was talking to Pastor Val the other day, and I said, okay. I said, now, I'm good at sitting a group down. I ain't forgot how to do that. We don't even believe in church discipline. We don't believe in sin anymore. We have culturated everything. And so therefore we have desensitized the conviction of Holy Spirit. This is how we quench the Spirit's fire. Oh, I ain't gonna die. That's all right. God gonna forgive me. I'm gonna go to heaven. Whatever. We quench the Spirit's fire. If we really believed in church discipline, most of these jokers behind the pulpit, most of these jokers with a microphone singing on Sunday, most of these people would be sitting in the pew. So we have lost that through our unbelief. Now everything is normal. Everything is accepted. Everything is all right. We condition ourselves. We stay in a habit and a sin so long until it loses its conviction. And the culture around us has quenched the Spirit's fire. Woo, is anybody hearing me right now? Oh my God. Woo, Rabakishkatora Rabasia. And I'm telling you right now that when we come to a place where we have come, even now, it's hard to see miracles, signs, and wonders. It's hard to see it. Watch this. Let's go to Mark chapter number 16. And many of us know the text, but let's just revisit it. It says now, go into all the world, preach the gospel. And these signs, verse 17, will follow those who believe. These signs shall follow those that believe. These signs shall follow those that believe. These signs shall follow those that believe. Oh my God. Woo, Rabakishkoto Ranaba Anda. These signs shall follow those that believe. And this is exactly why I don't let those people in the name of Jesus, because they come into Zoom and do things that I cannot even believe that that's what they do. It's unbelievable. So we're going to put a password on Zoom. Woo, Rabakashkete de la Bokoshka. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, these signs shall follow those who believe. I want you to see this. So, if these signs are not manifesting, then there's only one thing that we can say about it, is that we don't believe. Now, what are the signs? These signs shall follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. If they take up anything deadly, it will not harm them. And they shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. I got to go. The good God Almighty, this going to get deep. How do I quench the Spirit's fire? I quench it by my unbelief. I don't believe. You preachers, don't believe that you're supposed to heal the sick, cast out devils. You want to make the big deal about your sermon, but what happened to the signs? Well, you know, I didn't feel led. No, unbelief, you took it away. Now, unbelief is very different than non-belief, and we'll get into this in our next class. It's very different, very different. Unbelief is far more damnable than non-belief. Unbelief is more damnable and more grievous to Holy Spirit than non-belief. To have been a believer and then to take it away is more damnable than one who has never believed. How do I quench the Spirit's fire? Through my unbelief. I got to go. Woo! 7 a.m. Join me in the morning, Eastern Standard Time. Join me at 7 a.m. You don't want to miss this. I promise you, we're going to drill down. And when we begin to see how Holy Spirit will move among a people that simply believe, I believe we'll see Pentecost all over the world. I got to go. I love y'all. Woo! Glory to God.